Welcome to the Top Hill reaction portion. If you guys are new here, we really appreciate you guys for listening to us for the first time. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel if you guys like the content. If let us know if we're tripping, let us know if we're right. You know what I mean? We love criticism, so we appreciate you guys. Right. Okay. Tyler the Creator. We got to talk about this album real quick. Tyler dropped an album called Call Me If You Get Lost. We did do a reaction to Lumberjack. And I'm going to say this. When I hear a record and I don't like it off the first reaction, that's normal. That happens sometimes. I still don't like Lumberjack that much.
I was about to say, I knew I wasn't going to like it again. Like, I was looking for something that was going to be like, all right, I can see why I don't like it. Like, mm-hmm. It just was terrible. Yeah,
for me, it still wasn't it. But when I heard the album, that was the worst song on the album. And the whole rest of the album slaps to me.
Did you agree with our boy, Chad Visionaire?
Well, shout out Chad Visionaire. No.
He was tripping.
Yeah, he was tripping. So there's been a whole thing going on. And for me, I'm first talk about the thing. Tyler the Creator dropped this album, and a lot of people have been comparing his album to J. Cole's album, The Offseason, saying that, oh, Tyler made a much better album than J. Cole. My mind is, why do we have to downplay one person's album for another person's album being good? I know it's music competition and stuff like that, but I just found it really weird that people automatically pin these two against each other, when to me it's just like, yo, I like The Offseason. I can hear this in a certain vibe. I like this record as well,
too.
It's
two totally different types of music. Like, totally you can't compete when you don't compare. Like, right. It doesn't make sense. But at the same time, it's like, that's how you know that J. Cole's album was that much of some fire.
Yeah, it was fire. Offseason is still being played.
They're looking for a reason to shut it down.
Yeah.
And I'm not even a Cole fanatic. I'm right. Telling you, that should stop.
Yeah. But the Cole hate is real. But Tyler should definitely get his respect where respect is due. And I do understand when I did hear one person mention this, I was like, okay, I get it. Tyler, you know, he's a writer. Cole is a writer. Tyler's a rapper. Cole is a rapper. Tyler is a producer. Cole is a producer. They both, they're both in that bag where they're very, very involved in their music compared to other artists. And they're saying with Cole normally gets that shine and Tyler normally doesn't for those reasons. I was like, okay, I get it. But like you said, they make different kind of music for me. Tyler.
Yeah, sometimes Tyler be reaching for attention a little bit too much for me sometimes. So maybe that's why sometimes it be kind of like.
Yeah. I mean, I was never big into Tyler at first, but like when I started hearing his more recent project, it's been really growing on me. Like first when I heard Flower Boy, I was like, okay, this is dope. Then I heard Igor and I was like, oh, Igor is just fire. I love Igor. And now hearing this album, it's just like, this is just really great music, great body of work. Yeah, it's definitely growth. It's definitely growth in his music and how he's able to A&R, putting the right kind of people in his music in perfect places. It doesn't go without notice. So congratulations to Tyler, the Creator, making a phenomenal album. So let's go ahead and react to, he actually has two videos out. They're very short. Love it. I'm going to give these quick reactions real quick. The first record is called Brown Sugar Salmon.
Good day, sir Baudelaire. What can I do for you?
Oh, dude, I am so fucking hungry. And I just want to eat. Can I get the brown sugared salmon?
Okay, so our dinner plates this evening are the braised bohemian beef or the brown sugared salmon.
Yeah, I know. I want the brown sugared salmon plate with the potatoes, and I don't want Brussels sprouts.
I'm so sorry. We are out of that. The chef actually ran out of salmon because there was a trivial boat shortage at the lake.
So why did you mention it in the first place?
Right.
Because that's our specials.
Let me just get the braised bohemian beef with the potatoes, and I don't...
Mr. Baudelaire, I'm gonna have to check if we have the braised bohemian beef.
What do you have, bitch?
That's really how they be looking at you.
Are you fucking dumb?
Running next place.
I'm in charge, Mr. Baudelaire, and thank you so much for traveling with us. Is there a dilemma I can sort out?
I'm starving, and I just want dinner.
Oh, well, our dinner specials are the braised bohemian beef and the brown sugar
sandwich. I fucking know, and this lady keeps on telling me.
My name's Trina, sir.
Okay, well, Trina, sir, keeps saying it's no special.
It's
no
anything. Not no anything, Mr. Baudelaire. It's the braised bohemian beef with the brown sugar sandwich.
So fucking hot,
I think he's leaning towards the beef.
Trina, would you quadruple check if we have the beef?
Yes.
Breathing
because
he's a man. Me, I would
hit
the bitch.
He's like, all I can do right now is just, why are you looking at me? Go get the salmon.
We do not have braised bohemian beef.
Oh, jeez. I'm so sorry, Mr. Baudelaire. I have just got word that we are out of the braised bohemian beef. But we are now serving complimentary yogurt. Now, would you like strawberries or granola?
We are out of the yogurt.
Yo. That was funny. That was funny. It was funny too, because when I first saw that, I was like, I don't remember a record being called Brown Sugar Salmon. This is just a skit that's going along with his whole theme with his album. That was funny, though.
That
I felt that.
That was definitely funny. He said, I'm so fucking hungry.
Right.
I just want to eat.
Right. He's like, well, Trina, sir, go get my shit. That's hilarious. All right, so his record that I do know is on the album is called What's Your Name? Let's go ahead and get this joint listen.
His songs have been all very short, too.
Yeah.
California, you spend most of your life in cars, moving, traveling. Searching for somewhere to land. I don't mind tiptoeing across the globe for thrills. Like flying to Vienna to see a show at the Kunstmuseum. Or headed south to race dolphins on jet skis. But this time I ended up in the first village my boy told me about. That's when I met she.
Who would you do a nigga to start running up on you like that? Just like, yo, what's up? That's one loyal girl right there. Let's just clap it up for the loyal women right there. You know,
like, that man no damn mind. But that's usually when we be doing something what we do. That happens all the time.
Yeah.
You pay the motherfuckers no mind.
Yeah, like don't even exist.
That shit they ain't looking like now.
That's what you would have did right there.
Yeah.
Hey, dope record. What's Your Name? Also has Ty Dolla $ign on there as well. Great record. The video was dope. I really like his visual direction. I'm curious to see what this character, what this storyline is going to continue to bring. Very interested to see what else is out there with this. So, also
NBA YoungBoy series.
NBA YoungBoy. Yeah. So he has a lot of dope people on this album. You got 42 Doug on here. That sounds dope. You got Pharrell out here rapping. Like, Pharrell, I haven't heard Pharrell rap like that ever.
Really? Like, it's
super, super dope. Yeah, so he does, like, a lot of things where he doesn't really tell you what the features are in the record. Uh-huh. You got to kind of hear them, which is dope. I like that. I like it when you're listening to an album not expecting to hear people.
But we need to know, because nowadays so many artists be sounding like other artists. You be thinking you listening to one artist and you be like, yo, that's not him. That's a whole new artist.
I think, like, after the first listen, then it's cool. You know what I mean? Like, okay. J. Cole did that. Like, when the album first dropped, you didn't see any features. You're but right, then you're right. Then afterwards, they released what the features were. Like, I said, if more people did stuff like that, I think that'd be super dope. Cause
keeps you listening.
Come back. If you're an actual, like, album connoisseur, like, you like listening to projects, like, we appreciate that shit, but most people, they're just gonna listen to their favorite artists on the record.
Right.
So, yeah, and shout out to DJ Drama. I think DJ, normally I'm not a huge fan of DJs just yelling all throughout the albums, but I'm not gonna lie, the energy that DJ Drama brought to this was so dope. I'm not gonna lie. It really felt like a Gangsta Grillz dope album. Like, it was really, really dope. So, shout out to DJ Drama. All right, moving right along.